on your speeches, on the speaker speaking. Now, the third thing that you need to look into is, what are objectives? How are you going to evaluate your speaker? And most important, what kind of language are you going to use? It's very important. You can't stand there and say, you failed to do such and such and such, or you shouldn't have done this. Words must be encouraging. What I felt in your speeches was, what I saw was. These are words that are encouraging and it's very motivating. Now, you have to remember this, it's always about how to motivate your speaker. Last but not least, the most important of all, be sincere. Be sincere. This is very, very important. Let me give an example of how you can be not sincere. The speaker has done a really, really, really bad job. Alright? And you stand there and started saying, that was the best speech that I have ever seen. That was wonderful. Your vocal projection was well, you moved with certain purpose, and even the speaker felt like you're lying to him. That is not sincere. Now, this allows me to move on to the next point. Sandwich method. We all know about sandwich method. Who has not heard of sandwich method? I believe everyone does so. Who has used sandwich method before? I would like to share with you an ABC of sandwich method. A, B, and C of a sandwich method. Now, A of a sandwich method would be, appropriateness of a sandwich method. Is it really a need for us to use sandwich method every time that we evaluate? Not necessarily true. It's one of the methods, it's not everything. When we do not know how to evaluate, start with the sandwich method because it teaches us to motivate someone, go with a feedback, and then wrap it up with an encouraging words. So you need to figure out whether it's really appropriate to use it every time. Because if you use it every time, it becomes not sincere. It's not genuine anymore because you already have that script in you. B. When you are doing the sandwich method, is it a blessing? Or is it C, a curse? If someone does really, really well, do you really need to nitpick on what they do not do well? Or they have done a very, very bad job, and do you put everything in a nice context? What value would you bring to that speaker? For sandwich method, personally for myself, sandwich method is a showcase. It's a showcase in the sense that I need to show you how well I can deliver my evaluations. But it can be of value if we know when we can give a proper feedback. This is where I would like to move on to the next point. On evaluations, this is what I call the speaker to speech relationship. It's also A, B, and C. A, what kind of attitude does your speaker bring to the speech today? We've been in Toastmaster probably for the past 1 year, we've seen speaker that comes up with an attitude that I think I can nail this. It's an easy work. I don't need to prepare much, and they go all the way out, and you can see that the preparation is not enough. Now, if the attitude of the speaker towards his or her speech is not strong, then you need to put that into your evaluations and see what kind of attitude to bring in. If your speaker is sincerely trying to improve, the attitude is there, then you must give more value by looking at B, which is the background. when we move along the speeches, we might encounter members who are already speaker, who are already professional in their own field in terms of lecturing, in terms of teaching. And probably they have done numbers of humorous speech or even comedies. Now you need to take this into consideration. Mr. A speaks profoundly. Mr. B started to speak English not a long time ago. I'll give an example. I'll give a very, very example. It's no pinpointing to anyone because I have him here today, that's why I can pinpoint a little bit. Mr. A, Chris Wu. Mr. B, Amran. Now, you might think that this is a comparison. No, it's not. In our field, we have a lot of range of speakers ranging from professionals to amateur, even like myself as well. If you have known Amran when he joined, he couldn't do a simple introduction of the club. Now he can. So when you evaluate speakers who show attitude and their background is as a beginner, you need to take into consideration how can I judge him. You can't put on the same scale with a professional speaker. Now, for example, if Chris were to come in, you can't say that I can just give him whatever sandwich method that I can think of because he is already professional in speaking. You need to pinpoint, you need to be harsh on him, you need to be very, very picky in the way he delivers. Even minor mistake, you might need to pinpoint that. Because in every evaluations manual that we have, there are certain notes to the evaluators. Sometimes the note states, if this is the first time the speaker deliver such speech, be kind to them. So you need to consider what is your speaker background. And number three, judge or evaluate based on the criteria of the speech. This is something that has been missing in our club, not just only our club, but in clubs in Brunei. We evaluate not based on objectives. The objectives of the speech was to, are based on CC2, let's say, how do you organize the speech? Most important is to make sure that there's an opening, there's a body with 3 points, and there's a closing. And you can't think of anything, and the evaluator starts talking about, that was a great speech. However, I felt that if you could use the floor a little bit more, and you could use a little bit of more hand gestures, and the vocal projection was not so much eye contact, you need to look at everyone. So whatever I've given as an example are typical examples of how you give an evaluation. If I am a speaker, the first time I hear it, wow, sounds good. If the second, third time I'm sitting here and the evaluators give the same feedback to the other speakers, it's not sincere anymore and it's not motivating me, it's not helping me to improve. So this is what I've summed up as the ABC of both things. Number one is ABC of sandwich method. Number two is ABC of a speaker to speech. Now when we do an evaluation, how do we make sure that we can be motivating? How can we make sure that we can help the speaker to grow? Quantity versus quality. Have we ever evaluated a speaker where we went over time? We were given 3 minutes and we went all the way for 5 minutes because we have so much that we want to share with the speaker. Now, quantity doesn't mean that it's good. Quality is even more important. For what the 3 minutes or 5 minutes of evaluation or feedback that we have given, how much of it the speaker has taken back home. It's not about how much you tell them, it's about how much they pick up and use it immediately or the week after. It's not the 101 idea, but just one single thing that they can change that make them a better speaker. And it's very important as an evaluator that we need to understand how we can do this. When we're standing up here, when we're giving evaluations, it's not only to the speaker, other members are listening as well at the same time. If you felt that your points are a lot more and you can't put it all in the time frame, leave it and tell the speaker that I will talk to you after the meeting. Then you tell them other things. But whatever you are speaking on the stage, make sure it's objective based. It's for that particular manual. That's the quantity versus the quality when we are doing the evaluation. And one of the things that I always like to keep in mind, and this is what the distinguished Toastmaster Jeff, who has left us, has told me about. I and you. When we are giving evaluations, how many times we say words like this? I felt that it would be better if we could do this, this, and that. I thought that you would be doing this is such and such. It's about us. But have we ever stand in the shoe of the speaker? It goes back to the ABC which I've talked about. What are the attitude that it brings in? What is this background? And what are the criteria that you're judging on? We need to put ourselves in the shoe of the speaker. If the speaker are trying hard and they're showing sincerity in improving, we should add that into the points, and when we are giving the evaluations, it should be more on how, if I were in your shoe, you would be able to improve on. That is what I meant by the I versus you. Now, going through all these terms or this technicality, the next thing might be on your head would be how can I write down or what can I do during the speech so that I will be able to come up with a good evaluation within a limited time frame. The keyword is listen. We talk about we need to pay attention to the speaker. When the speaker speaks, the evaluators listen. So that when the evaluators speak, the speakers listen. There's a format which I use it most of the time to write down notes, and I found that this is very, very useful, and I would like to share with you today on this. Whenever we have a speech and we got the manuals, we always write down what's the objective or what's the criteria. We put the things down. Because every manual would state how would you judge or how would you evaluate. So the criteria, for example, number one, the body language, number two, do they move with a purpose? And there's always a cross and there's always a tick. It's always